the children of the Roanoke City Juvenile Home are being horribly abused. On at least one occasion, a 14 or 15-year-old girl was forcibly stripped by a male delinquent with at least one or two supervisors as spectators. A boy inmate died last week. The general belief of the boy's death was unnecessary. According to the information I received, the supervisor of that floor had left the building, went downtown to get a hamburger and a cup of coffee when he should have been on his job. It was known by all supervisors. When the boy had a spell, he had a tendency to swallow his tongue. It was 15 to 20 minutes before the other boys were able to get help. By that time, it was too late. Children had been kicked, hit by adults with a fist, threatened with guns, belts, and flashlights. These young people had been squeezed around the chest with the approval of the supervisor to knock them out. One was just recently knocked out, fell on the back of his head. A doctor had to be called. The boy is still suffering from this incident. Young girls have been taken into rooms by male supervisors without a matron in attendance on several occasions. Employees have gone to Mr. Owens to tell him of these problems. He has refused to let them talk to him. Another employee presented a plan to a city manager that would save the taxpayers money and make for more efficiency. Mr. Owens stated it was a $1 million idea. He was fired.